All right, guys. Well, a bunch of you guys wanted me to talk more about the Flipper Zero, judging from the comments that I had in the past. You can see on here the Flipper Zero has a little IR blaster, the same as you would find on your remote controls. There's a IR blaster here. If you push the button in the camera, you can see it light up in regular, viewing of the human eye. You cannot see that. It's also got one for your TV remote. You can see little infrared light flashes, so you can turn the TV on and off. But if you're just looking at it with your human eye, you cannot see it. So inside of our Flipper Zero, since we have that little blaster port on there, you would be able to see the light flash and fire. So when we go into our Flipper Zero, we have a little section here for infrared. Go into your infrared, you can choose any universal remotes, air conditioners, audio players, TVs. So you can see it's got just a general remote control. If you push that, it asks you to send it, and you can see the TV's off. Hit your back button, turn the TV back on. And it works. Okay, once you get done with that, you hit the back button, it'll go right back to where it was. Alright, next you can try the audio players. It's just a general universal remote. You get your volume up and down, skip previous and next, pause, play, power, mute. Got your air conditioners, turn them on and off. Obviously, I don't have one of those, so it won't work. But another thing you can do is you can learn some new remotes. So if you take this Ozeri fan and you say, learn a new remote, you can take it. Hang on, let me set you guys up here. You can take this remote. Remember, it's got the blaster on the front here. You can point it at your Flipper Zero. Let me get this thing to focus real quick. So you take your, all right, you take your Flipper Zero. Got the blaster on the end there. Push Learn New Remote. It'll say that it's searching for the remote. Point the blaster at the IR port on the flipper. Press a button, any button will do, and it'll say unknown, and it's got all the samples. So you can either retry if you fucked up the thing, if it didn't recognize your remote or whatever. You can resend the signal that you pushed whichever button on here, or you can save it. If you hit save, it'll ask you to push the keys to name the button. This is not naming the remote. This is just naming the button. So if you want to name the remote, you're going to have to start a new remote. So for convenience sake, I've gone ahead and I've saved a remote as Ozeri Tower Fan because that's the brand of my tower fan. And you can see in here, I've got on off, which is here, fan speed, which is here. The oscillation, which is here, timers up and down, and the mode button because I don't use the mode that much, so I put it at the bottom. So if I press this button, it'll act like I'm pushing this button on this remote. So you can see light changes colors, and you might be able to hear in the background my fan is actually kicking on. So I'll give you guys a look. There's the fan, and I'm going to push the button. Fan kicks on. You drop down to fan speed, and you can actually see on the unit that I'm just pushing this button here. gonna scroll back up to power. Watch it turn off. Meanwhile, the remote's still sitting over here on the desk, right where I left it. Well, I hope you all found that interesting and entertaining. Just remember, if you do have one of these, it is to be used in accordance with the laws. Do not use it for malicious intent. If you have an issue with one of your buttons, you can always go down and edit the buttons. You can either delete the button, or you can delete the whole remote. You can also rename your remote and rename your buttons. Also add new buttons. All you have to do, get your original, point it at the signal receiver, and then push a button. It'll learn your signal, and it'll keep your signal stored in here. So you can use this as a remote instead of that. Alright, I hope you guys found this entertaining and educational. If you want to see anything else, let me know. I'll do my best to accommodate. Alright, have a good night.